Thanks, Victoria. The Texas House passes a bill to fight Medicaid fraud. It also includes a host of measures designed to ensure Medicaid dollars are spent only on appropriate services. Senate Bill 8, approved Monday, was carried by the House Representative Lewis Colhurst, chair of the Public Health Committee in the House. Now, this is a giant step for the state, considering the Valley is the second most active area for Medicare and Medicaid fraud. Roshana Rodriguez is here to discuss a compliance conference that will be held in order to help providers become better informed. And good morning again, Roshana.
Good morning.
Thanks so much for joining us. And quickly tell us when this is going to take place.
June 18th and 19th at the McAllen Convention Center. That falls on a Tuesday and Wednesday.
Okay, and let's touch on the fraud that really takes place. Earlier, we were discussing a story about adult daycares and how they're sometimes targeted by physicians. Tell us about that.
Visiting a lot of the adult daycare centers here this last week, we had an opportunity to meet with many activity directors and owners, and they communicated that too many of our Valley providers are now visiting their adult daycare centers because it could be an opportunity for them to see anywhere between 30 to 150 patients at one time. And it becomes a concern for them because they're now questioning the medical necessity. You know, if you're having to come to solicit my patients at my adult daycare center, do they really have a medical necessity?
Right. This is where the fraud comes into play, because you mentioned that sometimes there's a quota for doctors to see maybe 150 patients a day, and these adult daycares sometimes don't have the transportation to be bringing in these patients on a daily basis.
Right. And that's the number one concern for many of our adult daycare centers, is the frequency of the transportation to and from the doctor's offices. Some of the adult daycare centers who have really good working relationship with some of the staff at the medical provider offices have indicated that they have a patient quota that they have to reach 150. And if somebody calls in sick, that they are to call the next patient in line. And that is a concern, and that, you know, that would be considered overutilization of services. And this is why we get so many calls that come into our office through the National Hispanic SMP reporting, do I have to go back to my doctor? I just saw him last week. Or why do I have to go to him again in the near future, in 2 weeks from now? And, you know, the patients now themselves don't want to go back to the doctor's office as frequently. We don't want them not to keep up with their medical appointments, because medical appointments are very important. But there does come a point when the patient does have to question their medical necessity and the frequency of how often they're having to go.
Right, and therefore the fraud. And why do you think it's so prevalent down here in the Valley?
Again, large provider population and large Medicare, Medicaid beneficiaries, and the fact that we have so many individuals that are violating the patient's right to choose the healthcare provider of their choice. It's not the doctor's choice, the discharge plan, or the social worker. It is the patient's choice to choose. And that's going to be part of one of the highlighted conferences topics that we are going to be discussing, is patient right. And that's something that Health Integrity is going to be effectively communicating within this next year, and we are going to be joining them in that effort. So the conference is for our Valley healthcare providers, and we definitely want to see as many of them out there as possible. Senate Bill 8 is very important. A lot of the aggressive initiatives that Health Integrity, ZPIC, the Medicare Fraud Control Unit is out there doing. We've got Department of Justice that will be joining us, the FBI. We'll have the Office of Attorney General's office out there. So a lot of information is going to be available to our Valley healthcare providers to teach them how not to become a subject of healthcare fraud.
Perfect. Well, thank you, Roshana. One more time, where are you going to be and when is this going to happen?
June 18th and 19th at the McAllen Convention Center. And people can call our office at 787-9524.
Perfect. Thanks so much for being with us. We really appreciate this message that you're bringing to the Valley. So thanks so much. Let's go ahead and send it over to Victoria.